genuine faith. The faith of Abraham is coupled with repentance. It is manifested in its results. And finally, there is a strong element of resilience. Remember, in the Bible, there are four kinds of soil spoken of by Jesus in the parable. There was a certain kind of soil that when the seed of the word falls into it, it brings forth some fruit in the beginning, some semblance of life. But when the sun comes up and when the tribulations arise, what happens is that it dies. It's not the right soil. It is shown up to be false soil. And there's only one kind of a faith that saves us. It is a faith that is evidenced by repentance, with the result, the fruit and change. And it is a faith that is resilient, just like that of Father Abraham. I came across this passage this week, Hebrews 6, great passage. That ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Abraham's faith is enduring. You can go on to verse 15. And so after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. There is that resilience, that endurance in genuine faith. Well, I'm not sure if you have absorbed it all, but I hope for those sincere seekers, it will be a benefit to you. And for those who may have been presumptuous, may the Spirit of God work His work in your own hearts. So real faith requires these three elements. But let me end by saying, therefore it is of faith, it is genuine faith, the faith of Abraham, that allows us to latch on to the grace of God. We are saved by grace. Do you know something? You're not saved by faith. Can I say this again? You're not saved by faith, you're saved by grace. You say, Pastor, what's the difference? Well, let me illustrate. Suppose you're on the 20th story in your HDB flat, and there's a fire raging in your flat, and there is no way out except through the window. And down there is that group of firemen with that canvas catch-all, and they shout to you, jump, jump, jump! They say, no, no, no! But you look around, there's no other way, and they say, jump, jump, jump! And finally you say, alright, I decide to take a leap of faith. You jump off the window ledge, and you land onto the canvas catch-all, safe and secure. Would you walk out of the canvas catch and then say to the fireman, hey, my faith has saved me? Would you say that? No. What would you say? Thank you for saving me. It was the fireman who saved you, but it was faith that allowed you to be saved. What saves us? Is it our faith? It's grace. It's grace. It's grace that saves us, but it is the faith in Him that accesses that grace of God toward us. Why is this important, you say? The importance is this, so that no man can glory. So that no man can boast, I am saved because I have great faith. No, friends, you are saved because of God's great grace. Wherefore, is there any boasting? None. You see, the proper understanding of the gospel results in ultimate glory given to God alone. There is no glory in man in God's plan of salvation. Not circumcision, not the law, not your works, not even your faith. It is the grace of God, saved by grace alone. We are all Protestants. If you have believed in Jesus Christ alone for salvation and life, and the message of the Protestants, the Reformation, the message of God's salvation is true still today. Man is not saved by traditions of man, but we are saved because of what the Word of God alone says. Sola Scriptura. We are saved not because of the law or because of our works, but by grace alone. Sola Gratia. We are saved because of faith alone in Jesus Christ. Sola Fide, Solus Christus. And what it all culminates is soli Deo Gloria. To God alone be the glory. May your salvation manifest the glory of God. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for the writings that you have preserved for us, that we may have a sure foundation with regards to the most important message of life. Thank you, you saved us out of your grace and not because of anything we have done, that the promise might be sure toward us. And we thank you that we are saved by grace alone, because it means all glory to God alone. Father, would you, through your word, build up our foundations? Would you, through your word, cause us to glory in you? Would you, through your word this morning, bring those who are still outside the kingdom and bring them into that saving grace? Would you awaken those who are in slumber of presumption and warn them and stir within them that they would not mindlessly slip into the pits of the fiery hell. Father, would you have mercy to so do your work in our lives? We pray, Spirit of God, that though the voice of man has ceased, you will continue to speak to each and every one of us. We thank you. We thank you for the glorious gospel message. We ask and pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless.